Welcome to another episode of Molo Consulting TV. Now, in this episode, I want us to look at the income statement. Now, the income statement is part of the financials of a company. Now, you'll understand that if you really want to, you know, to get deeper with the numbers of the company, you need to understand the income statement, the balance sheet, and the cash flow statement. Now, for today, we'll be looking at the income statement. Now, the income statement, basically what it measures is the profit and loss of a company. We'll try to break it down and just keep it simple, just to sort of, so that we can be able to understand exactly what is the income statement. Now, firstly, we have to understand that in the income statement, you would have sales, or sometimes it's called revenue, and then you will have cost of sales and the gross profit. Now, sales is, you know, what we need to clear is sales is not profit. Most people mix sales with profit. Sales is basically the income or the revenue of a company. When a company sells something, you know, that amount is the sales. Now, it does not yet include the expenses. Now, once you include the expenses and all that, then you can talk about profit and all that. But right now, sales is just when you sell something before taking into account the expenses of that. Now, and then it also includes cost of sales. Now, say you are selling tomatoes or any product, you know, the amount you use to buy those, you know, that stock, those tomato stocks that you're gonna sell, you know, we call the cost of sales. You know, those are basically direct cost. You know, it's related to, you know, that particular, you know, sales. Now, you will see later that it's not, you know, it's not the same as just any operating expense or sometimes called indirect cost. And then sales less cost of sales gives us what is called a gross profit. And then we have what we call operating expenses or just expenses. Now, these are sometimes called indirect cost. They are not like cost of sales, which is a more of a direct cost because it includes stocks or inventory. Now, these ones are directly not related to necessarily to sales, you know, meaning this could be, we could call it your overheads, you know, they don't include rent. You're going to pay that rent irrespective of whether you have those, that stock or not. Now, your operating expense will be your rent, your salaries. These are just an examples, your electricity, your telephone, all these are basically expenses. Now, from the gross profit, we'll deduct all these operating expenses. And then you would find your net profit. Now, the difference between the gross profit and net profit is that the gross profit is a profit that comes after the cost of sales. And the net profit only comes after you deduct all your operating expenses. Then you will find your net profit. Now, sometimes you will have a gross profit in a profit percentage, whether you classify it as a percentage or a net profit percentage. But basically, gross profit differ from net profit, you know, purely, you know, based on the type of expense that comes up. First, start the gross profit, which is sales minus your cost of sales. Like I said, cost of sales are basically your direct cost, which include stocks. It could include, you know, the transport to collect those stocks. Any costs that are related to that sales directly. And then you have your gross profit, then you deduct all your operating expenses, which are your rent, your salaries for employees, electricity, telephone, etc. This is also called indirect cost or your overheads. Then you will have your net profit.
Thank you very much for listening. If you have any question, please feel free to, you know, to type below, you know, send an email to info@